You get fill in the first question has five short answers, Nana, 1 mark each, and comes entirely from the grammar that is there in the textbook. Okay, one would be from pronunciation, plosive, fricative, whatever. This pronunciation part will do it later, and then coming to grammar, non-finite verbs and simile and metaphor vocabulary. So 1 mark from simile metaphor, 1 mark from grammar, 1 mark from spelling, and 1 mark from punctuation, 1 mark from conversation, and then you have value orientation and writing part, which might be asked in question number 5 or question number 6. So first question, short question, which has 5 marks, will come entirely from the first unit ka entire grammar, chutku chutku, 1 1 mark each. Okay. Now, in this, spelling will also be asked. Madam has done tenses, non-finite verb, from which one question will come. Vocabulary, simile or metaphor, one each question. Then comes spelling. IE or EI is there in your syllabus for the first unit. So, one of them will be coming. Like they give one sentence, fill it up with IE or EI, any of the choice. For that, 1 mark. Then comes punctuation and conversation, asking for information. One question will be given. How do you frame question to ask this particular information? That is given. And then you have writing skills, that is note taking or note making. Note making usually comes in question number 5 or question number 6, giving it with either soft skills part or value orientation. One of them will be asked. And note taking, you know, you've been doing it right from childhood, from 7th class onwards, 10th you did, intermediate you did. This is again a kind of a revision. Note making, whatever notes you take, there are two kinds of formats. One is block format, where you write only points. The other one is tree diagram. And the third point is mind mapping, a loose kind of a board work that you do. These three types you can make a note. And then we'll come to soft skills. You have time management. Soft skills and value orientation will be asked. Same part A, unit 1, I mean section 1, part A, question number 5 or question number 6. We are trying to create a model paper for this, that we will post it in your groups whenever we finish it. Okay. Coming to soft skills. Soft skills, time management is given for you. What kind of question does it come? So they might ask you, how do you manage time? Or why do you think a student needs time management? And give the steps to manage it. So for time management, what you require is, first you have to set your goals. Then keep a to-do list. Like today morning I have these many classes. First Telugu class done, commerce class done, or a optional class done, English after you finish this class done, tick mark. Then what all did you finish? Have a revision of it at the end of the day. How many are done? How many are postponed to tomorrow? So try not to postpone it to the next day. So procrastination, you should never do it. That is a part of time managing your time. And above all, you should relax in between. Somewhere you need to relax. Otherwise, if you don't relax, you can't work continuously and you will end up burning out. Burning out is a severe problem of late. Especially before the examinations, students burn out and they kind of get into panic attacks. Suddenly you'll fall sick, you have severe headache, all kinds of problems will be reported. For that to avoid, I mean to avoid all these things, what you should do is relax. And time management, have a timetable. Morning 15 minutes, I'll do this. The next 1 hour, this. Next 1 hour. So divide your day into little slots. Make it into bits and pieces. And goal setting, we have done it in the last semester. Most of you have written assignments also. How do you prepare your goals? They should be smart, small, measurable, attainable, reasonable or relatable, and then time bound. So fix such goals, keep a to-do list, and avoid distractions like watching a movie, spending a lot of time on internet for searching for something else. All this you have to avoid. And then you should remember to relax also. So soft skills mein time management is given in your first unit. It might come along with time and tide wait for none, or with any other soft skill in question number 5. Then coming to value orientation, in entire semester 4, you have 4 value orientations. In that, the first one, time and tide wait for none. What does it mean? If you are going in a share auto, that person recognizes you every day. If you ask him to wait, he might wait for a minute or two to pick you up. But time is a resource that you have, and you cannot use it for tomorrow or the day after. Time that you have now is only till today, this moment. So you have to utilize this time. It doesn't wait for anyone. Similarly, the tides in the ocean or a sea, tide after tide, wave after wave, they come and they go. They don't wait for anyone. Suppose you are near the beach and say, wait, I'm coming, just wait. Does it wait? It won't wait. So time and tide wait for none. So whenever such question is given value orientation in your exam for 5 marks, what you should do? First one, you try to elaborate, give the meaning, 2 sentences. Then try to explain it with examples, 2 sentences, 2 to 4. Then what do you think of it? 5th sentence or 6th sentence? That's it. 5 mark question, 7 sentences or 7 points you write. Time and tide wait for none. What does it mean? Explanation, 2 sentences. You can give the example of President APJ Abdul Kalam, or you can give the example of CEO Steve Jobs, what he said about time, and then Mother Teresa. All these examples you can cite. And how do you do it? Never procrastinate. Time and tide wait for none. So you should utilize whatever time you have now. There is no tomorrow. Think today is your last day of life and work it out like that. So no matter what, time will proceed. This is how you have to answer your value orientation question. Soft skills question, time management, whatever they ask, you have to either describe it, write a kind of short essay paragraph on it, give your personal examples and set goals, those 4 points. And then finally, you have time and tide wait for none. 5 marks question, what is it in 2 lines definition? Then give 2 examples or 3 examples of Abdul Kalam, Steve Jobs, Mother Teresa, and how do you manage your this particular moment, and what do you think of it, your personal experience. This is all about time and tide wait for none and soft skills. And what else is left? Any questions? Yes, ma'am. Yes, please. Spellings, 1 mark question again. Yes, madam.